It is not happiness that brings gratitude, but gratitude that brings happiness. Feeling thankful and not being able to express it is like wrapping a gift and not giving it.
Respected CEO, Dr. Ashok Kumar, beloved principal, Mr. Abraham Prakash, distinguished supervisors and heads, teachers, parents, friends, and our fellow council members, good morning to all of you present here.
Firstly, we raise our hearts in gratitude to seek upon the incessant blessings of the Almighty.
Today being Aryan's birthday,
and Nivedita's birthday being around the corner on 3rd June,
there is no better gift we could expect other than our investiture ceremony. And for this, we forever remain thankful to the Indian High School and the Royal School.
The 26 alphabets of English have fallen short to express our gratitude to our beloved teachers. As truly said by our comparers, we are like unpolished stones, and it is the great effort of our teachers which polish us into beautiful shining diamonds.
They have spent sleepless nights to make sure that we get the best grades and develop the best character. From learning to sing nursery rhymes to being given an opportunity to speak here is all the dedication and hard work of all our teachers, past and present.
It is rightly said that teaching is the only profession that creates all other professions. So, we thank all our teachers for bringing us up to this platform.
It would be a mistake not to mention the immense faith and blessings of our parents. From teaching us how to walk, to making sure we learn the difference between right and wrong in order to choose the right path, is all the uncountable efforts of our parents.
How can we forget our dear siblings and my great classmates over there, which they celebrated for me? They are my partners in mischief.
From fighting to always being there for each other, these are the people who we owe everything to for all the sacrifices they made to bring us here. Our parents and teachers have sacrificed a lot for us, and in return, they not expect anything from us.
However, it is our duty to make sure that their efforts do not go in vain. I am sure we all agree that it gives us utmost happiness to be the reason behind someone's smile.
And of course, our fellow mates who have always been ready to stand beside us in our good and bad. That is why we believe you, our dear friends,
are the pillars of our support and true source of strength. There have been times where we gave up, not knowing what to do. However, being rescued by the numerous solutions of our parents, teachers and friends. Being a leader is not leading from the front always. It includes celebrating victories from the back, but facing dangers from the front.
This is what we learned from our seniors, who have undoubtedly met the expectations of our teachers.
In the process of preparing this speech, the one thing that constantly kept us going was to exceed the legacy set by our seniors.
Studying in IHS right since the beginning has made us notice that each and everyone here has the potential of being a leader, because
we believe leaders are not born, they are made.
Hearty congratulations to our fellow council members. Together, we should make our teachers proud and exceed their expectations with flying colors.
Role models are everywhere, but it is a leader's choice to make whether you want to be
the fierce Shanti Rani, the wise Devi Abdul Kalam, the ambitious Nelson Mandela, the tyrant Hitler, or the autocrat Napoleon. It is absolutely up to us.
Albert Einstein once said, "Bear in mind that the wonderful things you learn in school is the work of many generations."
All this is put in your hands as your inheritance, in order that you may receive it, honor it, add to it, and one day faithfully hand it on to the next generation.
In the end, we would like to mention that a team is like a toolbox. Not one tool can do all the jobs, but all tools together can work miracles. Every tool serves a fundamental and unique purpose, which is unknown until it is tried.
So let us hold our hands together with this team spirit and confidence, ready to strive for one goal,
the success of the Indian High School,
and set a legacy for many more to come.
Once again, we sincerely thank everyone from the bottom of our hearts for entrusting us with this responsibility and making this investiture a memorable one with your presence. Thank you, one and all.